we get married, we must understand it is not a perpetual honeymoon. It is a big sacrifice. It is a very great sacrifice. Your life will change. Inshallah, you will be blessed with offspring. When your offspring come into the entire equation, your life will change forever in a different way. People think, okay, I'm going to enjoy, etc. I will have fun. I will this. MashaAllah. Allah might give you moments of joy, definitely. But the moments of sacrifice are greater. Your life changes, my beloved brothers and sisters. If you are not prepared to change your life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sake of that marriage working, how do you expect it to work? When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was towards the last few days of his blessed life, he reminded us to be kind to women. And he sat up one day and he said, I advise you good regarding women. And I implore you to be kind towards the women. So much so that there is one narration where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaks of the creation of a female. And he says that a woman was actually created from the rib of Adam alayhi salam. Now I do know that today there are a few modernists who deny that. And they say women are not created from the rib. I don't know if you've heard that, but if you see the internet, it's filled with all sorts of these type of words. The reality is they say it's an insult. How can you say we were created from a rib? My brothers, my sisters, what you were created from has nothing to do with you. Who you are right now has everything to do with you. Because if you say it is an insult to be created from a rib, someone else might say it is a bigger insult to be created from dust and from the soil. And there is no denial we were created from dust and from the soil. It's got nothing to do with what you were made from. Even if you were made from gold and silver, it would not have increased your value if you were a bad person today. But even if you were created from dust, your value is dependent on your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. My brothers, my sisters, following that advice to Muhammad, from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I want to tell you, normally in the khutbatul hajah that is read just before the nikah, and we will hear those verses, every verse has in it, ittaqullaha. Ya ayyuhan nasu ittaqu rabbakum. O people, be conscious of your Rabb. And at the end of that verse, Allah says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ. Be conscious of Allah, whose name you use when you want to make one another believe your story. Isn't we use the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We say wallahi, wallahi, every little while, right? You want someone to believe you, you use the name of Allah. Allah says, be careful, don't just use that name just like that. Make sure you know what you are saying. That's the name of Allah. Be conscious of Allah, whose name you use to ask one another things. And be conscious of Al-Arham. Al-Arham in the language actually means the wombs. And here what is meant is the women folk who are connected to you and the relationships that have come to you via the womb. So you are related to people, they are your siblings, they are somehow connected to you because Allah chose that they be connected to you. It was not your decision. I did not choose my brothers and my sisters and my uncles and my aunts. That happened. So Allah says, be careful. But the point I'm raising is the word taqwa. The consciousness of Allah, or the love of Allah so much that we create a barrier between us and the punishment of Allah, the displeasure of Allah. We create a barrier by fulfilling Allah's commands. The next verse, Allah says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ittaqullaha haqqa tuqatih. Notice the first one was, Ya ayyuhannas, O people. The second one is, O you who believe. It's becoming more specialized. O you who believe, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the proper way. Be conscious of Him in the proper way. The third verse also has the consciousness of Allah. Why? This is nikah. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, be conscious of Allah in your relationships. Don't involve in haram. And if you have involved in haram, remember Allah has the door of tawbah and repentance open. Change your life before you breathe your last. We never know when we are going to breathe our last. Change your life. It is not difficult. Ask Allah's forgiveness. Have the attitude of a mu'min. Today, the ummah is suffering. and we are struggling, and we all think the problem is someone else. We don't realize I am the problem. I need to change my life. I need to become closer to Allah. Every one of us has sometimes a little sin that we are perpetrating, minor or major, depending on what it is. Change it. Become a person who's closer to Allah. Stop it. Wallahi, it will help you. It will help the generations that are to follow after you. Be conscious of Allah. This is why Allah speaks about marriage and nikah. And Allah says, marry, but don't engage in that which is prohibited. It will earn the wrath of Allah. You affect society. You affect the community. You affect the ummah at large. So this third verse, Allah says,
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا.
O you who believe, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and utter that which is sadid, that which is upright, that which is straight. Watch your tongue, in other words. Watch your tongue. When we get married, a lot of us, you know, we are men seated here. I'm sure the women are also listening to what we have to say. A lot of us do not think that we are abusive with our tongues, yet we are dirty, filthy, we swear, we lie, we cheat, we hurt people's feelings. And the verse was read at the point of nikah, قولوا قولا سديدا. It's an instruction from Allah. Say that which is straight only. Don't utter windy words, dirty words, hurtful words, swear words, lies, falsehood, deception. Don't say those words. Many people, they divorce their wives in a discussion. Suddenly, talak, 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 and they think, now let's go to the Mawlana and try and sort our problem out. How? My brother, you were warned the day you got married to watch your tongue, and you did not watch your tongue. Now that you've shot all three shots from your gun straight into the chest of someone, you are trying to resuscitate them, and you don't realize what you've done is a heinous crime. It shouldn't even be done to the dogs. May Allah forgive us. And this is the condition of the ummah. This is what is happening today. Learn what divorce is all about before you get married, so that you do not do something wrong. Before you own a gun, and I'm not encouraging you to own guns, but it's just an example. Before you own a gun, you need to know what the trigger is all about. You cannot have a gun and suddenly you're playing with the trigger, and when you shoot yourself in the head, you go to someone and say, what happened? It's too late. You need to know what it's all about. So be careful of your tongue, my brothers, my sisters. That hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaks of a woman being created from a rib, and he says, you know that the rib is bent. If you, the end of the hadith says, in ذهبت تقيمه كسرته. If you try and straighten a rib, what happens to it? It will crack, it will break. And if you want to benefit from the rib, you benefit from it while it is not straight, while it is slightly crooked. Now, one might say, okay, is this an insult? Wallahi, it's not an insult. I think the meaning of it is more important. What is the meaning? The meaning is, you will never be able to change someone completely to your liking. They will be 50%, 60%. If you have 60, you are fortunate in today's world. Our parents, they had about 80, 90. I think it's dropping as time passes. But you are still very, very lucky, mashallah. Very fortunate. Wallahi, if you have 60%, I consider it a marriage made in heaven. Subhanallah. Before I used to say 80, 90, mashallah. There are still some, alhamdulillah. But I have to give you the same warning of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you want your wife to be like a pin regarding everything the way you want it, it's cracked, it's broken, the marriage will not last. There will be turbulence, your children will suffer, the relatives suffer, the relationships break because you were too hard. Many men, they think they are, you know, big hulks, and they want to prove a point, I'll fix you up. So the mother lives around the corner, you're not allowed to go there. That's it. Why? Because I said so. I'm the boss. The Prophet said, if there was a sijda besides Allah, it would be for me. You're lucky. I'm not telling you to do that. My brother, be careful how you talk. Watch your tongue. That same khutbah of nikah warned you about your tongue. How can you talk to someone's daughter like this? How can you talk to a human being like this? How can you talk to a worshipper of Allah like this? Do you not fear Allah? Why do you want to be so hard when there's no reason for you to be hard? No reason at all. Just your mazaj. You know what is mazaj? That means just your own fancies, your own will. That's it. I want to fix her. I want to show her who's the boss. I'd rather the whole world think I'm a chicken and I have a happy marriage than everybody thinks I'm a big boss and I'm struggling at home.